again with, oh my gosh, Dominik, how do you say the last name?
Chojnovsky.
Oh my gosh, Dominik Chojnovsky. The dispute over the legacy of Dabrowski, controversies and dilemmas. And that was the one.
Okay, thank you very much for getting me here. Hello to everyone. On the beginning, I want to thank organizers for having me here. And it is honor and great personal pleasure to be here because I am from many years I studied this theory and I don't have till now contact, direct contact with American society, scientific like this. So it is great pleasure to present in this beautiful city of Denver, and thanks again. I first contacted with the theory because my father have a book of theory of positive disintegration, and it was in my bachelor's degree, so like 10 years ago or something like that, first meeting with the theory, and I find it interesting. I read that book and I like it because it was original thinking, like not mainstream, I would say, in psychology and pedagogy. So I write first bachelor's degree connected with this theory. After that, master's degree connected with the theory. And finally, I wrote a dissertation about the theory. And after some improvements, I published a book in Polish, which I presented on the table. If you want to watch it, you can. So today I will present my understanding of the theory, how I understand the theory of the K notions of the theory in my understanding. First, I also look at how, in my opinion, main collaborator and main interpreter Pichowski understand theory and how Tiller understand the theory. And I show how, in connection with this, I understand the theory. So lastly, in 2014, some years ago, there was published an article by Michael Pichowski about the first level of the theory. Because first level of the theory was a controversial topic among researchers, because it allows very much spectrum of analysis. You know, you have like average people, normal people, but you also have psychopaths, big psychopaths like Hitler and Stalin, and Putin right now in Ukraine, who attacks Ukraine. And we have also people who are normal, living in society, doing just the right things, and they just not gifted, you know. So Pichowski thinks that this level can be erased from the theory, and this is fundamental change to the theory as I understand it. And he thinks also that it will improve it. So, in his opinion, development should not start on this first level because there is no development on the first level, because you don't have inner psychic milieu, so you don't have dynamism and you cannot develop. This is like a basic, maybe I simplified it a little bit, but I don't have time to go into every detail. In this article, Pichowski lists also a few mistakes that commit researchers, phases, not levels, not proper theory name, contempt for the second level, as well as some other things. But it is not so important. It is important, but not a core to be questioned, in my opinion. I agree with the most of this opinion, like theory of emotional development is not a proper name, because Dombrowski in Polish words, he also always said that disintegration is like the most important things in his theory. But I don't agree with this, that Pichowski accuses Dombrowski of using deceptive terms, like he thinks that Dombrowski commits mistakes, like sometimes he uses phases like levels, or he commits mistakes also. I think that Dombrowski not commit mistakes in his, I don't find it in his works. So I see, I think that I say about developmental potential that on this level, there is no developmental potential in the understanding of Piechowski. And Dombrowski is close to that, I would say. We have different fragments, we can discuss it, but it's close to that opinion. Piechowski also suggests that in the light of new scientific achievements, the whole theory needs to be reassessed. And this is one more thing in this argumentation, because if we really want to raise this level, with in these mistakes in this argumentation, because this level, if he allows for a large interpretation and large number of different individuals with different level, maybe not of development, but level of understanding reality, like psychopaths and average people, it is not too early to erase it, but maybe we should differentiate it with this level, yes? That are exist different individuals, and maybe some individuals and this level can develop, but in different way. I would talk about it more in my presentation. So another argument of the Piechowski is that the transition from the first level to the top one is impossible. So we cannot in a one life scope achieve five level of development. And I don't agree with that. And I think that it is possible. I would say next in later slides why it is possible and why we can achieve highest level of development throughout our lives. So another argument, people are born as good sensitive creatures, right? So it is another point that Piechowski makes that we should arise this level because people are born as a good, sensitive with emotional development. And it is one way of understanding. Yes, I think that Dombrowski don't agree with that because I know some articles of Dombrowski, early articles, I will show it later, in which he thinks that that primary integration is naturally existing in a young child at certain level. So this argumentation that good sensitive people can exist, I would say is closer to after born, a good sensitive child born and is good sensitive emotional development and so on, like Bowlby says, it is more close to Abraham Maslow and general humanistic psychology, it is not close to Dombrowski. Dombrowski is more original, I think. It's more than Maslow. And of course, it is also too much emphasis on environment, on the second factor. Like second factor is deciding in development of a given human, upbringing is deciding. I don't agree with that. So after about a year, Mendaglio and Tillier proposed critique of Piechowski article because they think that poor socialization does not make you a psychopath. And basically, I agree with them that it's mainly causes, and I think that Dombrowski thinks also like that, hereditary endowment. So psychopath is hereditary endowment. Genetic factors are the most important factors in the theory of positive disintegration. And I think that we cannot discuss that. Like in the, if we want to be in the spirit of Dombrowski's theory, he thinks that genetic is the most important factor. Okay. And we have also third way of understanding and interpreting of the theory. I based it and developed this way of understanding the theory by Maria Dzigwa-Kaczyńska. It was long collaborator of Dąbrowski in Poland. She writes a lot of articles in the same Mental Health Quarterly, in which Dąbrowski published till Second World War, till his death. And she also thinks, and she knows Dąbrowski well, that primary integration in its first phase is present in a young child. So it is level and phase, like continuously, because it is phase, because everyone experiences it at some stage when they very young, after they born. But some people are staying in the rigid structures and some developing next to higher levels. And we find in the article of Dąbrowski from 1946, it is early Dąbrowski, published in Mental Health, this is Zdrowie Psychiczne in po polsku, that he finds similar statement. So he also is close to that statement, that primary integration. He maybe changed it after some time, but at some point in his life, he will agree with this statement. And this is a quote that I translate from the work of the Maria Grzywak-Kaczyńska. It is from the book from, I used edition, if I remember correctly, from 1979, Zdrowie Psychiczne, Mental Health, which was, editor was Kazimierz Dąbrowski. And we see in this quote that she states that this state of primary integration, look, primary, not primitive, it is difference. Dąbrowski used these two terms synonymously, but if we differentiate, we can see that they have different meaning. It is different primary and different term when we use primitive. It is pejorative meaning when we use primitive. So she said that this is characteristic for a young child. Translation, which is more literally, will be normal state. Yes, she states like that. So some individuals stay on this primary psychic structure, and some develop only intelligence to serve their drives. Yes, and some individuals activate higher emotions, higher values, and develop through the process of positive disintegration. But this majority stays at the primary integration, and minority goes through the process of positive disintegration. And very minor minority goes through our levels. Because it is not like everybody can be gifted, everybody can achieve 5 level of development, even if we will be amazing upbringing and all this stuff, it not helps. So Piechowski, another statement that I find problematic, that Piechowski says that the theory is about multi-level development, not unilevel one. And he takes not only one, but two first levels can be erased from the theory. So unilevel disintegration in his way of thinking also not describes process of development. Development, multi-level development don't exist in the unilevel disintegration. It is partly true, because really multi-level development don't exist in unilevel disintegration. But if we focus on multi-levelness only, we don't see that development is a process. And process is way. And unilevel disintegration is critical to achieving higher integration on the higher levels. Another problematic thesis is that most of the people don't advance in the development because of the harsh society we live in. Dombrowski say that people who have great genetic developmental potential will advance even with the worst conditions possible. And this is literally in everything, everyone in his works, like even if the worst conditions, we can advance if we have very large developmental potential, if we have moderate developmental potential, if we have limited developmental potential, it is another way. Yes, upbringing have some importance. So I think theory is flexible, but not so flexible to say that upbringing is deciding, genetic is deciding. So in my opinion, we cannot say that level first is the outcome of the way society is if we look at the gifted people, but we can discuss it if we look at the average people. Another problem with this kind of interpretation is that this interpretation reduces the gap between those who are and are not gifted. Because look at this problem, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, reducing. You don't have, this is like contradictory in my opinion, because on the one way we want everybody to have possibility of double, of accelerated development, but on the other way we're reducing the gap. So who is gifted and who is not gifted? Only 3 levels? Like it is a little bit problematic. And main incongruences. So if we really reducing the role of developmental potential, which is, in my opinion, it is what Pichowski do, reducing the role of developmental potential in the development and thinking that more important is second factor in some ways. Putting too much emphasis on the second factor, as I said. And we can, this approach tries to not stigmatize anybody, but on the other hand, it rejects, in my opinion, the transformational dimension of Dombrowski's theory and flattens it, flattens. What that mean? Because in my opinion, based on the reading of Polish and English works of Dombrowski, theory is about transformation, inner transformation. So transformation happens from distraction, from disintegration. Disintegration happens at the second level of the theory, not on the third level of the theory. Without disintegration, we don't have a development. If somebody is already at the third level of the theory, for what reason he develops? He is like already developed. So he born like this way? It is questionable, I see. And weaknesses of this approach. In my opinion, this interpretation rejects inconvenient claims of Dombrowski about a part of society. People that on lower level of development and reducing the attention paid to negative emotion, but it is very important because Dombrowski thinks that negative emotion are a fuel for development. And this is why he thinks unilevel disintegration is important, because we used our negative emotion, our tensions experienced by us, to develop, to accelerate our development. This is like a fuel for development, and we cannot, without fuel cannot be the development. Yes, we must something that accelerated. And of course, simplification, because it is, I understand that it can be done to make theory more mainstream and make more people interested in the theory. And this in some way good way on thinking, yes, because more people will be interested because it's more egalitarian in some ways. But it really simplifies and make it more mainstream. Like, because originality of the theory, I would dare to say, is in disintegration, not in multilevelness. It is also important, but disintegration is the most important. No, and we can say that if we really do these changes, Dombrowski theory is no longer about disintegration. And high tension experiences that can lead gradually to higher emotions and values, it is narrow theory about gifted by definition people. Deprived of part of most interesting Dombrowski insights, in my opinion. Second way of understanding theory. I think that main contributors to this second way of understanding theory are Mendaglio, Tillier, and Grzywak Kaczyńska. Heredity is the most important factor. So this is second understanding of the theory that I understanding at level first is closer to the face. Like face and some point after that level, if you have rigid mental structures and you don't have enough developmental potential to make transformation. And it's natural in a young child who don't have time to develop extensive mental structure. So it is contradictory to Pichowski understanding because on the contrary, child is primitive after birth. It is not like empathetic on the first point. It's empathetic after some time. Yes, after some gradual disintegrations happen. And in this way of understanding, theory proper name is primary integration because it is not primitive. It is primary because all the people experienced it. And it's also a phase and also a level, but not in a rigid understanding. It is more flexible understanding. What are incongruences? I think that it's also uncertain to how to understand developmental potential in this way of interpretation, because from the one way of understanding, it is really similar to biological phase, because we experienced it everybody. And we must also assume to fulfill this interpretation that some individuals are stopped in this first level of development and don't awake their potential. So we must say that some people have limited developmental potential. They are not possible for them to fulfill it because of upbringing, for example. And they are stopped at this level of development. So this way we can say that most of society is limited to this development. It is correct from the dogmatic perspective. So from the Dombrowski perspective, yes, he say without scientific evidence that about 70-65% of the society is on the first level of positive, of the first level of the theory. And we can find it in Polish, in English books, everybody can find it, who wants. Weakness. It's pessimistic way of understanding theory from certain perspective. Understanding and introduces confusion. Is first level a face or a level? But when we this interpretation allows to get through that it's possible to get through all the levels of Dombrowski's theory. Look at this, like if primary integration is happening naturally, we can go through all the levels because everybody must go through the first level and after the second, third, fourth, fifth. So we can possibility of development to all the levels. It is also discussable in some more problems right here, but I don't develop it more. I developed it in the text which I write it, but I don't want to read all of it. So I think that Pichowski makes some good steps in his later article published in 2017 when he says and propose that it is part of the article. It is not the article. The article main topic is not that, but he proposed in this article that three first levels can be understood as types of development. And I think that is a good step, but not enough, like I said, in my opinion, of course. In my opinion, the main problem with the Lichovsky interpretation is that it avoids problem of mental awakening of the inner psychic milieu. So I think that it's not like this, that you already have inner psychic milieu. You don't need to develop it. You are gifted. You are have something like developed personality at the hand. You must activate this milieu, and it, in my opinion, happens on the second level. It is why second level is important, because we must awake our potential. It is also a cause that some great individualities commit suicides and don't develop through all levels of fear of positive disintegration, even if they have great developmental potential, because tension is too high. They cannot cope with that and commit suicide. And I think it is different way if we have great developmental potential and moderate developmental potential, because if you have moderate developmental potential, there more importance is given to upbringing, to the second factor, and also mental awakening, we can facilitate it as a educationalist or the therapist or counselors. So in my opinion, each modification of the theory which erases level one first is based on assumption that it does not describe development applying positive disintegration, but it's simply 0 point. So it is 0 point. It's nothing there. This is like flat. So a hidden point of Lichovsky's argument is that inner psychic milieu is already pre-existing of at individuals who possess enough amount of developmental potential. So I read it like that. They have already inner psychic milieu. They don't must go through second level because they already have it. It pre-exists. I don't think that Dobrovsky accepts that. Okay, I think right now I go to my interpretation. I think that there is possibility to develop theory, there is possibility to propose changes, but in my opinion, we must respect Dombrowski, because Dombrowski was outstanding person who have, I think, very wide knowledge, you know, not from one discipline, not from two discipline, from 4 to 5 discipline, philosophy also including. So I think that we can name 2 different types of development and third type of a developmental prodestructive change. I don't call it development, which very strictly can be compared to development. And in my opinion, first type of development will be a process of positive disintegration described, analyzed by Dombrowski. Because I think that it is development from inner pattern to inner pattern and based on transformation, inner transformation of the given individual. And I think that this type of development, like we don't really need a lot of changes in that because it is good described. Maybe some minor changes can be done, but not substantial. Like it is really good. And Dobrovsky know what he was saying, like development, not changes, because he we have 40 years later, the development of people who experience mental illnesses and psychoneurosis and neurosis don't change because of the few years, you know. Second type of development, which I will propose, is according to external patterns, so to influence of the external environment, social influence, and concerns the vast majority of society. So it is first level, basically. The vast majority of people don't experience disintegration, don't experience inner transformation, and their development, so-called development, is contained to the influences of society, to the external pattern. And I claim that developmental potential present in second type of development can be described as average in the statistical sense. So it is not like all people in the first level, in my opinion, don't have any developmental potential, like zero. Some people have limited developmental potential, but it doesn't allow them to transformation because it's too little. So development is treated like in theory of positive disintegration, more like a process of inner transformation, in my opinion, than self-improvement. That is my differentiation. Self-improvement not equal inner transformation. It is different. So I propose to introduce a distinction between the cumulative development method and transformation development method into the field of positive disintegration to complement it, not to change it, but to complement it. So it is another type of development. It's not based on inner transformation. It's based on the influence of the environment. And individuals who experience this kind of cumulative method of development are based on the upper stratum of the primary integration. So I think that first type of development described by Dombrowski we have easy to understand, because this is outstanding individuals who under good conditions can lead the entire society on the path of accelerated development. So Dombrowski in his later Polish works and articles started to develop sociological thinking, and he creates the term called positive infection, that higher developed individuals, if they connected with themselves, they can influence all the society. And this is the term. Second type of development, which is characteristic for average individuals who are susceptible to the influence of social environment. And it's different in the way, because there is no transformation and it is slower than development based on inner transformation, and is based on accumulation of knowledge. I describe it more precisely later. And third type of developmental prodestructive change is characteristic for prodestructive individuals. I call it prodestructive because I think that this term is more original than psychopaths. You know, it's more like prodestructive because they gain pleasure from destruction, from negative behavior. Psychopaths emotionally inferior, so they have high intellectual abilities, by then thought emotions, and especially higher emotions. They must be very strong stimulate, for example, harming other person to feel something. And it is special form of, I call it mutilated development, based only on a simple profit and loss calculation. So it is very good inscribed in the capitalist society in which we're living now. Capitalist society is because about profit, about being higher than others, about a career, about being the, you know, the smartest one, the having the most money, the best car, you know, and these people are really good in this. And these people influence the rest of society also. This is not positive infection. This is negative infection, I would call it. Dombrowski don't use it term, but we can call it negative infection. And they appear also to be attractive and people like them because they don't experience stress, emotional tensions. They are attractive because they high intelligence, they're very self-confident, and they also have personal charm. And as I say, proposed by me, cumulative developmental method is slower and relies on gradual accumulation of knowledge and learning, and disintegrative periods, if any, are rather weak. So it is consistent with Dombrowski works, but it's supplemented because these individuals cannot go through the process of individual positive disintegration. They can develop, but in the process of accumulation of knowledge, good environment, good social influence, then they achieve in a higher position. They not necessarily are bad people, but this is based on social norms, social rules, this development. What we must do, what is the most convenient way of doing things, the most proper way of doing things. We have in a family, we have pathological families, we have good families, yes, and they can influence such a person. So such an interpretation allows to solve the problem, so-called, of excessive elitism, because I don't think it's really a problem. People are different, they have different abilities. Some people are smarter, some stupid, more stupid, and this is like this. Dombrowski for sure think like that. He don't use maybe this term like that, but he thinks like that, that genetic factors are the most important and people are not equal. К сожалению, not equal. And we also not to stigmatize average individuals. So we don't say that they are like beasts, but people that want to destroy all the world, but they have the way to be good people if they positively influenced by the higher developed people, and also if they choose to accumulate knowledge and develop their cognitive abilities and emotional abilities. Of course, to certain limited way. What will be consequences of this solution? Of course, these people are also very easy influenced by strong men or emotional appeal of certain extreme groups, like because they are searching for easy solutions in their lives. So some scope of development on the first level is possible. Development, understand different. It is cumulative method of development, not transformative method of development. So it's two ways of development. Transformative only for gifted people, only for high cognitive and emotional abilities people, and cumulative, my proposal. And we have to make a distinction within the first level between two mental structures. So they are, in these consequences, there are two groups of people, prodestructive individuals who cannot develop themselves, and average individuals who can at a certain level, of course. Not level in the theory, but a certain level. And we go to the two kinds of understanding developmental potential. I think that developmental potential is the most important, one of the key notions in the theory. And in the literature, American literature also, there are two small discussions about this notion. So the first one, Pichowski's understanding, almost everybody can develop. Second factor, environment is deciding. Even limited developmental potential is sufficient to develop and be good citizen. It's not necessarily that you can develop very highly, but it is enough. You can be good citizens because everybody has sense the amount of developmental potential. This is how I understand Pichowski's positions. No inner transformation is required because we reject two levels. So you are gifted or you are not gifted, and you not activate. You don't have this fundamental disintegration. You have weaker disintegrations. You don't have this very strong disintegration, which allows you to find higher values, higher goals in your life, higher emotions, all that stuff. The second one, moderate developmental potential can be present, but it doesn't mean it is automatically realized. So if we have very strong developmental potential, we must realize it, or we going to do suicide, you know, I'll go crazy, have psychotic processes or something like that. But if we have moderate developmental potential, we can choose to stay safe, like going for drugs, going for alcohol, or, you know, going to primitive activities. So I think that developmental potential at some point, if it's moderate or limited, can be suppressed. And some individuals can unconsciously or consciously avoid effort related to its realization. So it is not that everybody wants to develop, even gifted people. Some people don't want to develop, don't want to experience disintegration because it is painful. And they choose another way, like desensitization of themselves, like through drugs, through alcohol, going to extreme sports, for example, everything what allow them to not to think about their problems, to not feel their problems. In my opinion, in Pichowski interpretation, the developmental potential is less important than social environment and upbringing. So he gives very strong importance. He says that developmental potential is needed notion, but he built stronger influence of the environmental factors of the upbringing. I don't think that is necessary true. It can be discussed and it should be discussed, but as between us, but I don't think that in the dogmatic way of understanding theory, it can be defended on the basis of Dombrowski's works. So I propose that first level may exemplify an alternative development pathways, and I assume that average individual in population is endowed with enough developmental potential to be a valuable member of its community. So I agree with Pichowski with that average individual in population can develop to a certain level. But it not means, in my opinion, that we must erase first level, because we can build it into this first level. We can complement, not erase. Second important hypothesis, which I want to put, is that gifted individuals have surplus of developmental potential. So I think this can supplement theory in the way of understanding that this surplus gives possibility to accelerate development, this higher amount of developmental potential. And this surplus is manifested in nothing different than mental disorders, mental illnesses, called by Dombrowski neuroses and psychoneuroses. A second thing that I want to clearly express, that it's not like overexcitabilities are developmental potential only consists from overactive abilities. Its interests, abilities of a given individual, is individual essence. And we have also dynamism, and dynamism, in my opinion, are also manifestations of developmental potential. Feeling of inferiority towards yourself, for example, or subject-object in oneself, are very important dynamics. Without them, we cannot experience accelerate development, and are connected with emotional overexcitability, because it is emotions which are the most important decay of Dobrowski's theory. And dynamism are even, in my opinion, more important than overexcitabilities, but are more problematic to measure them. So, to make it short, gifted individuals have overabundance of psychic energy, which is the fuel which accelerates development of the given individuals and makes it possible, but not determined, because we have examples of one-sided development. Very important. One-sided development, it's not a development that covers all personality of the given individual. So it is like limited development in a certain way to certain aspects of the personality. For example, in the certain discipline or the center, a certain activity. And I think that they must gain access to this psychic energy and learn how to use it. So in the process of development, they started to experience this energy, these tensions, we can say it, to make it more simple, simplified, and use it to their development, not to a destructive, self-destructive activities. Remember that Dombrowski in 1934, if I remember correctly, wrote a dissertation about self-automutilation. It is important dissertation of this author. And I state that the amount of owned developmental potential is, of course, hereditary. So it is hereditary, it must be hereditary, because it is consistent with the theory. What are good things of that interpretation? It is dogmatic in a certain way, because some individuals are able to develop themselves through all levels, and I think it is possible, and it is not a bad way that some individuals, it is not like all the people started to develop through positive disintegration, we can make sure about that. It is also more inclusive, because allows more people to achieve higher level of development. And acknowledge differences between gifted and not gifted individuals, because gifted is different than non-gifted, and we cannot reduce the gap between gifted and not gifted, because it is based on genetics and hereditary endowment. What is, and I want to also propose, it's connected with the updated developmental potential version, the place of psychic energy in Dombrowski's theory. Because I find in the Polish books, and especially in the dissertation in a psychology about self-automutilation, published 1934, that he, Dombrowski, through his Polish works, and used, and this in later works, in the earlier works, notion of psychic energy. In the translation on English of this dissertation, it is bad translation, basically. Psychic energy is translated like tension. You know, tension is not a psychic energy. This is two different terms in Polish also. We have energia psychiczna, psychic energy, and tension, napięcie. It is different. So the person who translates don't understand. Just it. He don't operationalize this notion. So he used it like just psychic energy. It is interesting, in my opinion, and this is translation corrected by me. It is quote from this dissertation. It may be assumed that the mechanism of these processes is similar to that of compulsions. The mental restlessness increased by autosuggestion when seeking release takes the route indicated by the intention and in this way releases the accumulated psychic energy. And it is words of Dombrowski, but corrected by me to be real. Earlier it was accumulated tension. And I check out other works on Dombrowski in Polish, and in works in from 1979, this notion is also used. And exemplary quotes. 1964, Dombrowski. I have already indicated how important for pedagogy is the principle that in the development of an individual, the activities of stimulating and strengthening the energy on one level must go hand in hand with inhibiting, weakening, denial of stimulations at a lower level. So we see again energy. Something is called energy, which exists in individual, and individual uses this energy to transformate themselves. And it is support my interpretation. Because we transform themselves with using the fuel, which is psychic energy. Another quote, Dombrowski, 1958, Polish article. I think that one of the most important Polish articles that allow to fuller understand dynamics, because it is about psychological evaluation article. And we see again, energy, transform energy. Yes, so we see the third factor strives relying on the disposing and directing center on higher level and the personality ideal to weaken the lower levels of the inner environment and to transform energy obtained from the inhibitions of many lower dynamics into sublime energy. So we see that it's about transformation and about energy, psychic energy. And again, I would not read it. You can see it, various psychic energies again. And I can go like that, but I don't put all the quotes in the presentation because it would take too long. So it is interesting to see the bibliography to dissertation from the 1931. It was defended in 1931, published in Polish in 1934, published in English in 1937. But that translation, as I said, that Dombrowski mentioned psychological types of Carl Gustav Jung. He doesn't refer to previous work on Jung, Psychology of the Unconscious, republished and revised as samples of transformation, where, and it is important, Jung included his modified concept of libido as psychic energy. So it is concept of libido in Jung approach is completely different than the approach of Freud. Freud connects it with the sexual drives. Jung thinks that energy can be modified and expressed in various different ways. For example, building a house or creating an outstanding work. I claim that this notion of psychic energy is inherent in the Dombrowski's theory of positive disintegration and can be also applied to better understand of inner transformation with connection to the concept of dynamics. So in my opinion, I would not develop this more. I could, but I don't have so much time. It is connected to inner transformation, concept of dynamics, and cannot allow us to better understand the theory. Like it is supplement, it is not like changing everything. It is also interesting to think, in my opinion, of developmental potential, a certain amount of energy, which is assigned to each person from birth to death. So it is like hereditary endowment. You have libidinal force, and some people have larger force, larger amount of psychic energy, which can be manifested in psychic illnesses, mental illnesses, and some people have lower energy and have cannot do it, cannot manifest, cannot develop in accelerated way. And it is dangers of this interpretation, which I must to consider, is that it can make theory oversimplified. Why? Because there are also some people that want like, oh, it is all about energy. It is only energy. It energy can be created in different ways, like, and all the concepts started to be understood this simplified way. If so, it is dangerous, dangerous in my opinion, but it can be also positive. It depends of the interpretator. So it is interesting to that, that those mental illnesses in the interpretation of the theory which I propose are manifestation of surplus psychic energy, and we can, some of these can be gradually transferred and make a human self-updating and self-realizing person. I don't use the term self-actualizing on purpose because it is different theory, it is Maslow. Dombrowski don't like it. Some of them can be distorted and make a human really unhappy and excluded person. Of course, an approach putting energy in center of the theory concerns certain interpretation of dynamism. I don't include it into this, this presentation because it will take too long, but in book it is described. And it's closing, closer to finish that on the beginning, I think. Out of, I put a quote which I translated from the late work of Dombrowski, weight article of Dombrowski, philosophical article published in the important Polish journal. And it is to show that Dombrowski think that the most important are emotions in this theory. He don't think that intellect is the most important. He don't think that imagination is the most important. He don't think that sensual overexcitability is the most important. He think that emotional excitability is the most important in his theory. And this is why some people use a notion of theory of emotional development, which is not correct, yes, but it is theory of emotion in a certain way. And emotional development, because if we don't have emotion, we can disintegrate. And last few slides concerns topic why unilevel disintegration is central for understanding Dombrowski theory. Because if you make energy a central notion, we must consider that this level have central meaning for this theory, because on this level, enormous amounts of psychic energy are activated and used for either psychic transformation. So it is consistent, in my opinion. It is like puzzle in the, which is correctly elements of particular elements which are put into holistic higher theory. And I claim that it is exactly activation of the developmental potential by an individual that happens on this level. So in the most cases of accelerated development, we must activate developmental potential. And with activation of developmental potential, it comes also activation on the inner psychic milieu and activation of the different dynamics of inner psychic milieu, which are manifestations of psychic inner energy. So I think that is consistent. And without activation of psychic inner milieu, it is, and developmental potential, it is not possible to achieve higher level of development. It is not like we can, oh, I'm just developed, I'm born at this way, I don't must disintegrate. It is like, I think we can say that, but it is not longer Dombrowski theory, in my opinion. It is like different theory. It is updating, totally changing. And This is exactly why Dombrowski claimed that stressful environments with hard conditions can stimulate growth, because it stimulates disintegrative processes in the given individual. It is true, and we can find in Polish and English texts examples of that and assertions of Dombrowski that there exist rare examples of people who begin their development from a high starting level, for example, third level of positive disintegration, but exceptions prove the rule. This is not like some cases is enough to refute all the theory. So in this level of development, tension, stress, conditions of environment plays double role, disintegrative one and developmental one. It is developmental because it is stimulus in shaping a new self-image. We need stimulation. Without stimulation, we cannot develop. We cannot disintegrate. And we have Tiller quote, which I think is a nice quote to say it right here. The transition from level two to level three involves a fundamental shift that requires a phenomenal amount of energy. This period is the crossroads of development. From here, one must either progress or regress. I show that quote because it shows that even disciples, I would say, of Dombrowski use this term, also not elaborating what this term means. Yes, energy, psychic energy. Finishing. Dombrowski theory is not about multi-level development, not only about multi-level development. It is important, but not only one important thing. In eminent personalities is about process that leads to achieving this higher level of development. So process, way of achieving development is very important. Second, developmental potential requires activation, awakening, and it takes place on the second level of positive disintegration. So it is not like we have developmental potential without activating it. We can choose to not activate it if we have limited or moderate developmental potential. If we have great developmental potential, we cannot choose because we either go crazy or develop. And amount, strength of disintegration experienced by individual is not always the same. And in the works of some of the collaborators, like Żywa Kaczyńska in Poland, of Dombrowski collaborators, we see that they always also said that disintegrations don't must be necessarily inscribed into the five levels. So they also like discuss this problem. But inner struggle is always present. So it is not like without inner struggle, harmonious development, without disintegration. And without it, psychic energy, without inner struggle, psychic energy is not generated, new dynamics are not developed, and person is not going through the process of positive disintegration, unless it is another theory. General conclusion. Theory of positive disintegration allows large scope of interpretation. In this way, it is still unfinished project, and I agree with Piechowski that we can change and modify the theory in certain aspects, but we must discuss it, I think, on the larger forum. It is not like we have people like Dombrowski right there and someone say, oh, it is like that, and we all must say, okay, we agree, we don't discuss. No, we can say, okay, it is my interpretation. If you don't like it, you can criticize, you can write an article, say that I say bullshit or something like that. I don't have problem with that. It is science. So it is not about being like a god, a scientific god or something. And much depends, in my opinion, on which fragments of Polish and English Dombrowski text we focus on. So we can't put a fragment and like, oh, I put that fragment, and my interpretation is correct. But second person choose different fragments, and his interpretation is also correct, but he chose different fragments. It is why it is correct. So it is like not emphasizing some hypotheses and less focusing on the other aspects of the theory result in different interpretations. And we have these 72 hypotheses, and we can modify, discuss, and play with them. Of course, it is a long-awaited moment for each intellectual creator of the theory when his successors achieve intellectual maturity and are able to propose the interpretation of certain concepts. And it is good that Pichowski proposed his interpretation, and it is good if Tiller proposed his own interpretation, and it is good if anybody else proposed his interpretation, because it is good for development of the theory. In my speech, I cover only part of my research, so I focus on some key notions, in my opinion, at least. And I try to preserve original character of the theory, because I think that theory is good theory. And propose some modification, which I hope sheds some light on important constructs from which they consist of. And I would say also that it is interesting, and I in the book is not the Polish publisher don't include it in the book, because in Poland we have like don't like neo Marxist perspective and critical pedagogy and critique of neoliberal education because of certain historical communism and all this stuff. And I also see that it is possible to connect Dombrowski with the critical perspective and critique of neoliberal education today. So education which focus on the race to the top, on the stronger will survive, survival of the fittest, all these notions which you have in America. Like if somebody have to achieve success must be the strongest, hardest working person. So it's emotional tensions, no. Problems, disintegrations, no. It's like Dombrowski proposes alternative education, which is related to humanistic values aimed at supporting the growth of developmental potential present in students. And we see this in his work Introduction to Psychic Hygiene in Polish in 1979 published books, which is not, of course, translated into English. So Dombrowski concept of education, and I tried to do it in my dissertation, aimed to shift center of gravity towards developing in students a higher emotion nucleus, teaching them empathy and sensitivity directed against primitive tendencies of neoliberal societies. So we can claim that in modern societies, capitalist societies, primitive tendencies, psychopathic structure, pro-destructive individuals get support from the environment. Like they are strong, they are, don't experience tension and can achieve success, higher money, better cars, So they are like good people for the majority of population. They aspire to be like them, like chiefs of corporations and all that stuff. I think that Dombrowski would not agree that these are the most, these are the best examples of development, accelerated development. So not only intellect, not only intellectual capabilities, but emotions, and one more time, emotions. It is psychotherapeutic education. And thank you very much.